What's up, my Fina loves? It's Miss Fina D, and you're watching Finatainment Unfiltered.
Before you even watch this video, if you missed the video I posted earlier, put this video on pause. Click the very first link in the description below. Please go and watch that video, and everything else that I talk about in this video will make sense, okay? All of this been going on for a while, but the video that I dropped basically started most of it because Indy is now addressing it head on, okay? So go and watch that video and then come back. That segment you just heard was recorded before all of the events and drama that happened at Hearts of Reality a few weekends ago, okay? Now, I posted an Indy video that I referenced at the beginning. So if you missed it, go ahead and watch it. But then I promised to come right back with all of the drama that was going on. But for those of you who are not aware and are new here, I am currently in school completing my PhD. So yes, this is just a hobby, a fun kiki, okay? Your girl is educated. So I'm back in school completing my PhD. And I do have businesses outside of YouTube. And I also have my main YouTube channel. So I got wrapped up in school, my businesses and everything. And I had to put the Indy and the Taylor and all of the little gossip and Joseph and everything on hold. However, I do have a segment on my main channel that I called Lost Files Friday. And that's the segment where all of the videos and content that I intended to post that I didn't get around to post, I post them on Lost Files Fridays. Lastly, I do things in order. So I will be starting with the Instagram Live of Indy grabbing Joseph's face, invading his personal space and all of that. The Instagram Live that set the internet off. And when I tell you, Indy got dragged. And when I say dragged, not physically, it's a slang, okay? Meaning people were throwing shade and all of that, okay? And yes, we're going to get into the whole Uber situation and all of that. But let's start from the beginning. Let's get into it.
Bom dia, Brasil. Boa madrugada, California. Tô aqui.
I am finally here.
This is our hotel. This is my room. And you guys have to guess who is my new roommate. Just one tip. The person is from the BB24 house. So, who do you guys think it is?
Why am I trying to do my makeup? Indy, what is
that? I hope they don't charge us because
I'm
first thing, I just got here. What's just going on? Guys, guess who is here? Lost in his life.
Oh. wait, let me see my friends. Where'd they go?
They give me a hug. You don't miss me? What the fuck? Oh, baby. Where are they? They went to work? It's okay. They left?
I came here to check in fast. Mi amor. We're back.
We're back! I miss you!
I had such a luck. You see what it took for me to get here?
I know. And I, everyone's asking me, what's Joseph? Where's Joseph? And I'm like, guys. He missed the bus. You need to give your ID, honey. It's not like you were not. Sorry, you were not Will Smith.
Oh, my God.
How are you?
This one, I got so scared.
I got here. I was like, I need to pay attention. Oh, there's someone else. Everyone's getting here late. Where were you? Excuse me.
Now I'm here.
That's that, guys. That's how you guys get.
To mi amo.
Yes, our gentleman, Mr. Abdin.
Yes.
Abdin has two
Abibi.
Why does everything go wrong?
No, they broke my luggage. I flew Spirit for the first time in my life and they broke my freaking luggage.
You flew Spirit? I'm saying I'm laughing at Spirit, but I took a bus here and missed the bus.
Oh, it's worse than me.
And Will is here calling someone. I don't know who. He's doing something. He's busy apparently.
Don't be upset, that baby. Do you want a shot? I can get a shot for you. You look upset.
No, no, no. I'm just trying to figure out what room I'm in.
I just saw your man. Going upstairs, and I will leave him alone. Cause oh, he's here!
The reunion.
Cause it's loud in there.
I want it to be noted. I got here before the Amazing Race people.
Okay, but they won the show. We didn't
know which way. Actually, it cost me like 20.
At least you got a girlfriend. When did Ian want to go to the run? I'm like, you got a best friend.
A headache.
Like,
yeah, you got a best
and
friend.
And a headache. That's all. Bye, guys.
I'm supposed to be checking out December 11th.
I wanted to allow the entire Instagram Live to play before jumping in because I do have a lot to say. Before we get to the obvious, Joseph, let's talk about other moments. This moment right here. Okay, you see him on the phone. You know that he's busy, but you're on Instagram Live. Even if he's nice and cool and is not going to get upset, still back up and back off because you don't even know what conversation he's having. Okay? So I don't even think India is aware sometimes when it comes to boundaries. Then this part right here where she was being so sweet, saying, oh baby, you don't have to be upset. You want me to get you a shot? Okay, she was being nice in that moment. Let's just say he was actually upset. He wasn't. He was trying to get his room. But let's just say he was upset because we all have our moments. That's not something he wants on Instagram Live. You are just shoving the phone in his face without him even knowing that he's going to be on Instagram Live. People in the background talking about when they're checking out and all of these things. This is like privacy and private moment and information that shouldn't be out there on Instagram Live. I heard one person say, check out that it's December 11th or something like that. Regardless if the area is protected, you all have security or whatever it is, you still have to be careful in that moment. So, like I said, back to him. So what if he was upset in that moment? Take the camera away and all of that. It's not your place to announce it. Oh, baby, you don't have to be upset. You want a shot? That's not something he wanted on Instagram Live if he was actually upset. Luckily, he wasn't and everything worked out. And I know I talked about it longer than I expected to, but I just wanted to break down that sometimes I don't think Indy acknowledged the boundaries that she's crossing and things like that. That you see someone on the phone and that's your moment, they just back away and know that they're busy, but yet you still stick the camera in their face. It might not seem like a big deal, but it is a big deal when you're not self-conscious and you don't know when to say when and when to realize, okay, let me go somewhere else because this person is obviously preoccupied. Even though, like I said, she means well. Now, back to Joseph. Okay, now let's get into these screenshots I took for the people who keep saying Joseph also needs to talk to Indy about boundaries. He's allowing it. Does this look like someone who's allowing it? Or does this look like someone who is like, okay, there she goes again. She's placed me on the spot. I'm on Instagram Live. I'm not trying to embarrass my friend. Does this look like someone who's shook, okay? He looks nervous, all right? Like I said in one of my responses, I said it's not that Joseph doesn't want to set boundaries. It's just that sometimes she just shoved the phone in people's face on Instagram Live. No heads up, no nothing. He's not going to embarrass her. But most of the time, he looks nervous. And I was right. Look at this man's eyes. Look at how comfortable and relaxed Indy is. Because she's just happy to see her friend. And she's relaxed. But look at Joseph's body language. His eyes look... that man look shook. Like... I'm wifed up, okay? So that's my point. Even if Indy means no harm. She's just a touchy feeling type of person, and sometimes she doesn't know boundaries. She doesn't know when to say when. She doesn't know when it's like, you know what, just cut off the phone or back away and give people their privacy. You can't just turn your phone on and shove it in people's face. Like this moment right here. So Joseph said, nobody sit on my lap, I'm wiped up. When I tell you this lit up Twitter, oh my gosh, because Amira, is that how you say her name? Yeah, she's the one who said something about no one is going to tell or something like that. If someone sits on Joseph's lap, okay, because they're all trying to squeeze in this Uber, no one is going to tell and make a big deal, especially knowing that he's in a relationship with Taylor. Regardless if they were joking or not, Twitter did not play. So let's get into some of those tweets. So it looks like Amira realized that Indy was on live and she had no idea. And so she allegedly said that she's going to watch what she says around Indy, saying that Indy just go on live, no heads up. Exactly what I said. Even her own friends are saying it. I know that you want content. The etiquette is to announce I'm on live. But Indy wants that real, raw reality drama for her subscribers, and she doesn't care who she puts at risk or compromise. But even your own friends are saying it. You could incriminate people. People could be just having a moment, and here you are, Instagram Live, recording their conversations and things like that. It's like, girl, put the phone down, have fun, or at least have the courtesy to announce, I'm on live. So people can know. So this person wrote that Amira comment about watching what she says on live just further proves what I have always believed. People rarely change after Big Brother. Who they are in the house is who they are in life. The difference is we see curated versions and no longer see unfiltered huts. How many different ways he gotta tell the thirst buckets he wiped up? This just confirms how great of a human being Joseph is and how true my intuition was about Amira from the start. She is a nasty person, period. I don't want to see anything about her. She doesn't even deserve any kind of attention. She's awful. Just asking for a friend. You think it's okay to sit on a lap of a guy in a relationship? Indy responded, oh, I didn't do that. I didn't do that. And then this other person is simply explaining what happened for people who did not see the video to watch out for Amira. She didn't know Indy was live and they were getting in an Uber. Joseph said, no one can sit on my lap. I'm wiped up. And Amira said, no one is going to tell. And go ahead and read the rest of that person tweet. Somebody Taylor comments, Amira trying to get your man, and this other person replying to Indy, you and Amira really need to stop disrespecting Taylor. I hope you all apologize to her. The comments and tweets got worse for Indy, so bad that she was clapping back on Twitter and Instagram. But since we are focused on the Uber situation right now and Amira, let's stay focused on that. Now, when I wrote in a title about chess, not checkers, or Taylor clapping back, you know, at jailers, her supporters, she and Joseph supporters and all of that, this is what I meant.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Is it the girl that was trying to hook up with my man at a charity event this weekend?
And in case it's too small to read, Taylor wrote on the video, I'm a sit on her lap. Nobody tell. Now, if you remember the Uber video, that's exactly what she said to Joseph, okay? Taylor is simply playing chess. I'm not going to let these girls see me sweat. I'm not going to allow them to think whatever they're doing is affecting me. I'm not going to allow them to think I'm insecure or intimidated. I'm not going to allow the haters to think that Joseph and I have an issue or we're fighting because of these girls. I'm not going to give the public exactly what they're looking for. Some of the people in the public, exactly what they're looking for. Now, if I have a problem, I will talk to my man privately. We will address it, but I will not publicly acknowledge the nonsense or make these girls feel like they got anything on me. That's how you move. That's how she's moving. She's playing chess while they're over there flirting, being thirsty, doing their thing. I'm over here booked, blessed, and busy, walking carpets and doing my own thing. I'm so secure that I don't have to be with him in his presence 24/7. I know what I got. I know my man. I'm good. Even if she's not good, that's for her and Joseph to talk about and handle behind the scenes. But publicly, I am going to put her on my Instagram and behave like everything is all good. Calm people down and shut down the noise. But that doesn't mean that Taylor... What I'm just saying is that Taylor knows what she's doing. I won the money. The show is over. Whether I'm friends with these girls or not doesn't do anything for me. I have my real friends. I got the man. I'm good. I'm just going to laugh it off and move on because this is what people want. They want the drama. They want the back and forth. They want the hate. They want something that they can hold on to and say, aha, that's the Taylor we're talking about. And every time she beats them at their own game. And as far as Joseph drawing boundaries and all of that, he does. I mean, this man was saying, I'm wifed up. Don't sit on my lap. You know, keeping his distance and doing everything to respect his relationship. Now, someone shoving the phone in his face and invading his personal space, it's like, okay, I'm not going to embarrass my friends on camera and be like, don't touch me, get away from me, you know, but you could see it in his face that he was terrified when Andy did that, you know, doing a kissing gesture towards his face. That's when his eyes turned like this. But for the most part, he was very pleasant to her. That's his friend. When she started to grab his face and made the gesture of a kiss, regardless if it was a friendly kiss, that's when his eyes looked like this. Speaking of Indy, I have tweets and other things to read because Indy did clap back. But before we get to the Indy story, let's go back to the Taylor story with these girls. Taylor would just have to learn for herself. And I don't even think at that point she's going to make a big deal about it. She's just going to peacefully and quietly move on because they do not deserve that type of attention from her anyways. But the way how Taylor is moving with these girls, and when I said she's going to have to learn on her own, it's because her story reminds me of this queen right here. Stunning Cachet from Love Island USA season 3. If you are not aware of who she is, just go through the channel and go through the dollar sign playlist and you can learn all about her journey and her story. But she was on Love Island USA season 3. She was a fan favorite. Long story short, she was on the show with Single. You know, they had a love triangle. I'm not going to get into that. If you know, you know. Or go ahead through the channel, like I said, and learn about it. But long story short, she left. Single left the show. And they reconnected outside of the show. And they started dating, okay, after the show ended. But some of her co-stars, they were not here for her. And all of her supporters warned her, told her to be careful. They did exactly what's happening right now with Taylor. And Cachet reacted exactly the same way how Taylor is reacting. I mean, identical. Reposting, copying an Instagram live with those same people, telling her supporters to please calm down and stop the drama. I mean, every single thing to the T. And the same thing with the guy, Single, okay? The girls all over him flirting, people that she considered her friends. It was a hot mess. But after reacting the same way how Taylor was reacting, which there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with being drama-free and giving everyone second chances and the benefit of a doubt, okay? But everything her supporters warned her about happened. But Cachet had to learn that for herself. There's nothing that her supporters or anyone could have done to stop her. And that's what Taylor would have to do. She was at the event with all of the drama. She did meet Joseph and she posted this image right here. And she tagged Taylor in it. Met your man, not you. Okay. And Cachet and Taylor been, you know, DMing each other. Taylor was on Instagram Live and she had nothing but amazing things to say about Cachet. So it's cool that they know each other and they're getting to know each other. But I love what Cachet did. I'm going to take this picture. I'm going to tag your woman, okay? And I'm going to post it. I don't want no smoke, okay? I'm good over here, and I'm making sure I'm acknowledging Taylor because I've been there. I know how these supporters can get, okay? I don't want no parts of it. So she made sure she tagged Taylor and was like, hey, girl, I met your man.
Brasileira não tem minuto de paz. Ai, socorro, Deus. Socorro, Deus.
Yes? Not going to Qatar. Caralho, que merda, hein, gente?
It's okay. She's crying around the park. Come on, don't cry.
You guys are Americans, you guys don't get it.
No, I get it. I know. Soccer's a big thing for Middle Eastern stews, but it's okay. We're supposed to be having a good time.
We're gonna have a good time, but it was like, I'm mad.
No, I know.
I'm gonna drink, so since I'm not going to Qatar,
just drink it away.
I'm gonna cancel my flight.
And if you are someone who's been watching the World Cup and you're into football, yes, I know y'all call it soccer in America, it's football, whatever. But yes, you know where Indy is from. She's from Brazil, and they did not make it to the next round. And so she was crying, and Joseph stepped in as a friend and was there for her. No one is saying that Indy and Joseph cannot have a friendship or that Joseph can't have friends outside of Taylor or female friends. No one is saying that. They are just simply saying she just needs to know boundaries. That's all.
We're so blessed. Obrigada, Deus. Thank you, God.
Yep. All right.
I swear. And the best part is, like, we know how to enjoy life. Sometimes God gives you the opportunity and people just don't see it and people don't take advantage of the moment, and we do.
The moment we're taking advantage of and we're enjoying is that we were feeding the birds and the bus left us.
Yes. And now we're like leaving this place with all the food that we could get.
Oh yeah, they were like,
so we don't need to spend money on food for the rest of the weekend.
Yep.
Oh my God.
Now this moment right here. So you have people saying if Indy and Joseph missed the bus together and she's wearing this same bathing suit, who took this video right here where you can see all of her cheeks? So now people start dragging Joseph and dragging Indy. And I'm like, did y'all not watch the show? Wearing bathing suit around each other? Just because someone is in a bikini or a one piece or a bathing suit and you're recording a video doesn't mean you are sexualizing them or looking at their body in a certain way. Taylor wore a bikini on the show, and this could have been recorded before the bus left them behind. It could have been somebody else, but even if it was Joseph, as you can see, Taylor isn't tripping about it. So let's move on. But I'm just setting it up because I'm going to put some of the tweets on the screen so you all can understand why people went in on Indy like this. You really are kissing on someone's man. It's disrespectful. We all know that you are faking it with Taylor. I hope they eventually cut you off. Indy responded, oh babe, I'm not kissing him. For God's sake, accept that I'm not into him. He is my friend and we are like family. That's all. Do you give a about disrespecting your friend by hitting on her man? And he responded, I think his girlfriend would be clear if anything that I do bothers her. We all know how directly we are to each other. And you know she meant direct. Like if Taylor had an issue, she doesn't see Taylor as a person to hold it in. Taylor would be very upfront with her and direct and say, girl, you know. So yeah, let's move on to the next one. You need Joseph to be relevant. I followed you because I thought you had a hint of decency after the season, but I was wrong. Stay hating on Taylor like you did all season. Just disrespectful trash. Indy responded, you still here giving me some engagement. Keep loving me, sending you light. Now say what you want about Indy, she's always going to capitalize, okay? So when all of this was going on, of course she's going to promote her subscription on Instagram. If y'all want to see the Instagram live that I took down with Joseph and made it a subscriber only content because I posted it for free and I was getting dragged, go ahead and subscribe, okay? So she promoted this on Instagram and of course on Twitter, and that led to this response right here. So this person responded, "But I will never buy anything you are selling, including your subscription. I will donate to any charity Taylor and Joseph are a part of. If you like being hated on, to be relevant, knock yourself out, boo. Everyone's eyes are opened to your thirst now." Laughing face emojis. We have more comments of people calling Indy fake and saying that she doesn't like Taylor. It's on the screen. You can go ahead and read it. And as you can see, they were not letting up, okay? Won't Indy go and find herself a man? She's been looking real desperate these past couple weeks on social media. You just keep giving off weird behavior. Like, go get your own man and stop trying to everybody else man, okay? And we don't want to... A mess. Indy again, I don't really care about your opinion. I'm his friend and God knows my heart, so his girlfriend. He is not my type and he is a good friend. Get over it and leave my page. Bye. Okay, girl, we saw you on the tapes. You like him. He turned down your advances. It's okay. You've moved on. I get it, okay? I have placed those live feed recordings in a lot of my videos. So if you go to the JLo playlist, you can watch them there, but I will not be including it in here. I get it. Joseph moved on and it's all good. But yes, there was a moment there where you liked him romantically. And then you liked somebody else in the house. You know, the person that Taylor spent her last few days with. Yes, that guy. We're not going to say his name. So yeah, you did like Joseph. So Indy responded, "Oh babe, get over it. I'm not disrespecting anyone, not that you deserve, but I'm dating someone that you may know and I don't need people's, you know, boyfriends. I'm fine. It must be Joseph secretly." Indy responded, "Nope, little taller." So this person responded, "Quit lying. If you have a boyfriend, it seems is correct. You are disrespecting them." Okay, Indy responded, "No one said boyfriend." So basically, she said, "I'm dating, okay? I'm dating around, dating someone. I didn't say I have a boyfriend or I'm in an exclusive relationship, so."
Remember when Indy said she was dating somebody and y'all might know who it is?
Oh my God.
What? So cold, Dales.
I already know Tiffany is gonna lean into some mess, but they were clearly joking, okay? They're not together. Indy and Kylan, and even if they're together, no big deal. But Indy wrote that in hopes that people will leave her alone. All people are saying, you can be married and still be inappropriate with someone else's man. They're just saying, know your boundaries and stop doing too much. Now, Indy did go on Instagram and she did a whole ask me a question situation. And in there, she talked about, oh, you know, this is my culture. In my culture, we're very, you know, touchy feeling. But she said some things that rub people the wrong way. So because I'm already at almost 30 minutes, I'm going to end it here. And I'm going to save the rest for part 3. I promise. I'll be right back with that video. I'm going to let this video rock for a few hours. But I'll be back. Because I have a lot more to say. And everything I have to say plus everything she had to say is going to push the video to almost an hour. And I do not want to do that. But all I have to say about that is, Indy, if you want people to respect your culture and understand that, then you also have to respect and understand theirs. Not every woman is going to be like Taylor. Not every woman is going to be okay with you being all over that man. And Taylor doesn't have to tell you. As a woman and a human being, you should understand boundaries. Another grown woman shouldn't have to call you and say, hey, can you stop doing this? You should know when to say when. So for her to respond on Twitter, you know, tweeting that, oh, Taylor hasn't said anything to me. There are things that we should already know. There are times in your life where you should know when to say when. Where another grown person doesn't have to open your mouth and say, can you stop doing this? You should know when to say when. That's what I said in the beginning. She doesn't know when to say when. Like when the guy was on the phone, he shouldn't have to tell you, can you please stop sticking the camera in my face? I'm on the phone trying to figure out my room situation. This is a private conversation. That man shouldn't have to literally open his mouth and tell you that. You as a human being should be able to understand, oh, he's on the phone, he's busy, and maybe, just maybe, he's having a conversation that all of Instagram doesn't need to hear. Let me take my phone from in his face. People shouldn't have to literally tell you that. On that note, I'll be back with a part 3. I'm wishing all of you well and take care. And let me quickly add this part. Joseph came to Indy for help because his vest or something was stuck on his back. And she tagged Taylor and basically said something along the lines of, you know, where's your girlfriend? She needs to be here helping you do this. So one of the employees from the park were able to help him do it. And so Indy is still missing the point. Her whole point for recording that moment was, look, even when I'm minding my business, he still comes to me, even though you all think I'm the one that keeps going to him. Indy, you're still getting it wrong. No one is saying don't be his friend. Don't be around him. Don't have the amazing relationship that the both of you have. They're just saying, not knowing boundaries, you need to learn that. That's all. That's all of these people are, you know, tweeting to you.
Thank you all for your love and support. In this section, remember to always have the God bless attitude, which is being positive at all times and seeing the good in every situation. Have a great day, guys. God bless.